Scotty, I appreciate your live interview with Dwayne McClain. You summarize everything with great advice here.
Don't be afraid to be wrong or make a mistake, too.
You mentioned a few gatekeeping channels, so I want to share some thoughts and theories with the hopes of saving you from wasting your time getting confused by all the disinformation out there. You brought up magic. I believe the biggest threat of magic is simple and doesn't depend on any supernatural forces. It depends on lies and pre-programming through pop culture and the power of suggestion. The pre-programming from television and the education system runs very deep. Magicians of today will say something which triggers their target to believe they mean something else, because every single superhero or main character on a television movie show will respond in that particular manner. For instance, every time somebody coughs or sneezes on somebody else on television, we see somebody else catch a disease. Like, this is repeated over and over again. The magic is that when people believe a lie that was not told to them directly, it's more difficult to convince people that they are deceived than to deceive them. This condition of willful ignorance is entirely natural, and it's based on what you said. These people study human psychology to the nth degree. Think of the inventor of this canola sniffle scare scamdemic. Whose idea was it? Who's the first guy to think of this? Like, that guy has bragging rights. That guy is the world's smartest magician. So I wouldn't go chasing any truth about supernatural, occult, cartoony type magic forces. Now, you mentioned castles and mountains. I find that particularly fascinating. I'd like to draw your attention to some theories about the use of blimps, airships, and hot air balloons in the past. It seems like it was a lot more common than we can imagine. There's a link below from a gang called Space Busters called Blimps in the Belfry, where they theorize that people travel from place to place within a city and from city to city through air balloons, or hot air balloons, anchoring from towers to towers. So people would climb up church towers to board a hot air balloon and then climb down a church tower so as to not to have to travel through the roads. Which leads to another psyop. The mud floods is a total bullshit distraction designed to entertain you, but ultimately to waste your time. I recommend that you watch all of those mud flood channels that you mentioned with the audio off. Look at their slideshows and try to arrive at your own conclusions, or try to invent a narrative of your own. The old photographs are interesting and worthy of research, I believe, in some other way, but there's no big secret of mud flood. They're showing you photographs of excavations for the construction of city sewer systems, where pipes are laid down over top of the roads and then buried, just like things are done today. The first floors of all street-level buildings were submerged. So just keep in mind, every time one of us truth or tards looks at an old construction photograph and thinks we're seeing a mud flood, there's a construction guy out there laughing at us. The flat earth psyop serves many purposes, but superficially, it's there to hide a much deeper truth that's infinitely more astonishing and important, much more than the shape of the earth. The most common Google gatekeeper has the job of leading truth or tards to believe we're limited and confined to a dome. That belief serves the purposes of the globalists perfectly. The psyop is real, but don't let it control your thoughts. For instance, you wouldn't be looking up and measuring the light bulbs hanging from the ceiling if you had to install new carpeting or flooring, would you? So as long as the truth or tards are confused about the shape of what's under their feet, and they're not concerned about its size. Before you waste too much time and effort consuming all the gatekeeping that's out there, I recommend that you review the following dissertation by a guy called Vertex Puppy. It's called The Great Switcheroo, whereby he demonstrates how the global deception works because of the physiology of our eyeballs, which wobble in their own orbits, as we like to say. Cheers.
But I'm about to log off. I'll be right back. OG Scotty B links. Go subscribe to his channel. Cool dude. Y'all be out. I'll be right back, y'all. Hold on.